Hello everyone and welcome to The Weekly Show episode number 9. We're just one episode away from our 10th episode anniversary spectacular with tons of surprises. That comes next week. But first up here today, let's get to our celebrity quote of the week. Tom Ridge, former Secretary of Homeland Security, writes in and says, "I lied in the past about the terrorist threat levels. I'm lying now to promote a new book. So believe me when I tell you, I love The Weekly Show. Thanks." Hey, wait a minute. In other news, we have our meteorologist, Mark, standing by, live, who's reporting from an unknown location, but it's out in the sun. Mark, how are you doing?
Thanks, Matt. I'm out here in absolutely beautiful conditions. 80 degrees, not a cloud in the sky, just like I predicted. Thank you.
Uh-oh, Mark. Do you mean to tell me you trusted your own forecast and didn't pack an umbrella with you?
An umbrella? Why? It's absolutely perfect conditions out here, Matt. What do I need an umbrella for? Oh, why did this happen to me? I said it was going to be perfect. You guys are going to pay for this, right? Dry cleaning?
Definitely not. That is not in the budget. Nope. Alright, we'll check back with Mark later in the show for his 5-day forecast. Right now, though, it's time for some rock-hard news with our Middle East correspondent who's reporting live from an Iranian revolution. Tell us what's going on out there in Iran.
Well, Matt, there is a lot of angry people. There is a lot of unrest. People feel like they have been cheated out of their votes. We were really looking forward to this election and possibly a new president.
We stopped hearing about Iran in the news, so I think a lot of people just assumed that things calmed down there and went back to normal. Is that not the case?
That is not the case. Unfortunately, there has been difficulty getting a lot of information out of the country because the Iran's government has been monitoring what's been going on. As you heard, a lot of Facebook accounts were shut down, Twitter.
It's mostly young people that are revolting, right?
Well, half the population is under the age of 30, so
That
would make sense.
Look at you with your facts. Well, what are most of these young people revolting against? I mean, are they upset that they don't get to see American TV and movies?
Oh, life, there's more to life than that. They were looking forward to reform, more freedoms.
What type of freedoms don't they have?
Freedom of speech.
Well, you like to talk, so I'm sure you could not survive in Iran.
Actually, to take that back, to be fair for the record, there are plenty of countries that censor freedom of speech, such as China. They control the newspaper. So why are we always talking about Iran?
I think we talk about Iran because they have nuclear ambitions and many are scared of
Ahmadinejad.
That's it. And quite frankly, he seems like a crazy person. Wouldn't you agree allowing him to get nuclear weapons would be like handing over the keys to a bulldozer to a 5-year-old child?
I agree, but according to international law, that's been thrown out the window. We've got to be fair. Israel has nuclear weapons, Pakistan does, I believe India does. You can't dictate to one country saying, listen, I'm allowed to have something and you're not. It just doesn't work that way. So how are we even going to come and sit around the round table and discuss this when there's no negotiations here?
On that happy note, do you think we should trust Aqua Marmalade with nuclear weapons?
I think there needs to be an end to all nuclear activity. We gotta be fair, we need to turn back to the United Nations. They are not doing their job, and it's probably because a lot of stronger countries are not allowing the UN to do
its purpose. Don't get me started on the UN. The only thing less effective is Kirstie Alley's weight loss program. But do you think the US should be helping these Iranians topple Ahmadinejad?
I think whatever's going to happen in Iran needs to come from the people within. They're smart people. They could achieve what they want. The last thing we want to see is the U.S. being blamed on interfering, which there's already speculation as to them somehow igniting the protests that are going on. We don't want a repeat of Iraq. We don't want a repeat of Afghanistan. We just want peace in the Middle East.
Thank you for your reporting and giving us the hard facts.
You guys should go. Everyone should go visit Iran. It's a beautiful country.
I hear Iran is da bomb.
Literally.
Who ran?
Iran.
Okay, we'll see you again soon. Remember, folks, if you have any comments or questions for any of our correspondents or contributors, email them to weeklyshowtv@gmail.com, and they'll be answered in the coming weeks. Next up, it's time for film fight where no movie is safe from a verbal smackdown. Let's get to it. Welcome to Film Fight, everyone. We're here reviewing a brand new movie, Quentin Tarantino's Inglourious Bastards, starring Brad Pitt. And let me just start off the bat here and say, I thought it was eh at
just
best.
One eh.
That's all I give it. And actually, it just reminded me how much I liked Kill Bill that much better, because there's actual... some of the soundtrack from this movie was lifted right from Kill Bill. It's some of the same songs. It's very awkward, quite frankly.
Really?
Yeah.
Well, Matt, do I need to seek help? Because I was actually a little bit disappointed by the lack of gore in this movie. And there's a decent amount of scalpings and throat slashings. And I really did like the scene where one of Brad Pitt's soldiers went Gallagher style outside the German bad guy's melon. I like that part, but I really did want to see more. Maybe that's just me.
Hey, that's fine. I wanted some more Quentin Tarantino style humor as well. I thought a lot of these scenes were a bit humorless. And we're burying the lead. The fact that this is nearly 3 hours. This movie was torturous to sit through.
Torture? Us?
Yes, I felt tortured, quite frankly.
And the Nazis were getting tortured. But you're also forgetting there was a great performance by the German bad guy, Hans Landa. Very eccentric character. He's almost worth seeing alone.
I would actually agree with you there. So that guy was very humorous. So let's talk about our final recommendation here. I'm going to sum this up by saying I found it to be a torturous 3 hours with some spurts of fun.
And for me, there was a decent amount of gore, but I guess I wanted more.
Let's now do some quick reviews of some other movies out there. Right now, District 9 is being ballyhooed about by many critics as a great surprise late summer hit. I'm here to tell you it is overrated. It's pretty good, not great. None of the human characters are of any interest whatsoever. They're all boring. There's one alien that you root for. Other than that, it's the... really not that great, but it's a creative movie. It's trying to evoke some of Cloverfield magic to make it seem realistic, so...
That Cloverfield magic. Cloverfield hard to bottle that.
It's hard to bottle. District 9 is doing its best. There you go. And there'll definitely be a District 10. So if you want to see the prequel to District 10, go see District 9.
Well, Matt, another movie out there is The Goods. Has Jeremy Piven not exactly stretching his acting chops? He's back again doing the whole narcissistic, egotistical thing that he does, probably better than anyone else. It's not the best movie, but it is entertaining, and I have to admit I did laugh at a few parts. The Will Ferrell cameo was pretty good, too. Shockingly, first time in about the last 5 Will Ferrell cameos that's actually been worth it.
Yeah, well, then maybe that's worth seeing, but... On that note, folks, we are glad to wrap it up here. So we'll see you next time for Film Fight, where there will hopefully be better movies that we can strongly recommend, as opposed to this lukewarm reaction to the 3 movies we saw here. Great! That's the show! Oh, wait! We forgot to check back in with meteorologist Mark. Are you dry enough to give us the 5-day forecast now?
I'm okay. I'm just gonna see you guys in a bit.
Oh well, I guess we'll have to wait until next week for the weather. But folks, thanks for watching, and remember, next week is our 10th episode anniversary spectacular. Tons of surprises, and we're going to be reliving some of our best moments of the past 9 episodes, and unleashing some crazy plans for the future, so the best is certainly yet to come. Thank you, folks, for watching. We will see you next week for the Big Ten.